Even though playing the clarinet is just getting a little piece of wood to vibrate through this tube, it's very, very simple. Sometimes it feels quite complicated. And the reason for that is that there's all kinds of different things that have to be doing different things, sometimes directly opposite of each other. And that's what I call pressure paradoxes. And I'm going to talk a little bit about how you can learn these things and use them to improve your clarinet playing.
My name is Josh Gu, and after years of studying the clarinet with some of the best teachers from around the world, I am excited to be sharing my knowledge with you. So go to quickstartclarinet.com or check the description on this video to see all of the wonderful resources I have to help you reach your clarinet dreams. And of course, subscribe to this channel for weekly clarinet and music tips and tricks.
So what I mean by a pressure paradox is where you want to be doing one thing, but simultaneously nearly the opposite of that. So one example is we want to be using more air and stronger air pressure, but we also want our fingers to be really light. We want the fingers to be quick and snappy, but we don't want to have any tension in our hands or being too firm and squeezing. So it's all of these things where it's like, you want to do one thing and put energy in one direction while simultaneously not putting too much energy in that direction. And it creates all of these sort of little paradoxes where it's like, well, do I push or do I not push? Do I squeeze or do I not squeeze? I think a perfect example of it is in the embouchure itself. There's so many different pressures that need to be happening. For example, the top lip needs to be firmly coming down and really engaged into the mouthpiece. But at the same time, we don't want to be having the reed pushed down into the bottom lip, or we don't want the jaw closing and putting extra pressure on the reed. So there's all of these things, and even sticking with the embouchure, we want to have this bottom lip be really firm so that it's not dampening the vibrations of the reed, but also we can't push the bottom lip too firmly against the reed or else it'll dampen the vibrations of the reed. Maybe another way to put this is there's a lot of things that sort of have to be just right. You have to have the Goldilocks embouchure pressure, the Goldilocks air pressure. More air is always the answer to pretty much everything. However, it's possible to use too much air or use the air in the wrong way, where there's this paradox of, well, I want to use more air, but if that air isn't focused and directed right at the reed in the right exact way, it's not going to work, and it's going to be maybe too much air or produce a spread or not great sound. And that's why it takes so much effort to learn how to play the clarinet and to play the clarinet really well, is that you have to have all of these variables going in the right direction in just the right amount, and that can be quite challenging. Now, the reason why I wanted to talk about this and make a video on this is because I think a lot of times people aren't aware of these pressure paradoxes, and I think if you become aware of them and think about them a little bit, it can really improve your playing. So, for example, I think one instance where we're often not aware of this, or this issue sort of causes problems for us, is in the air in the embouchure, where we're trying to use more air and support with more air because everybody always says that. I always say that. You should always use more air. I stand by it. But sometimes we get into an issue where we're working so hard to use more air, we find ourselves also using more embouchure pressure, and that defeats the purpose. So if you're trying to blow harder and then you end up squeezing harder with your mouth because you're trying to exert more force with the air, then you'll actually be sort of inhibiting your own progress and creating an obstacle for yourself, because the more we pinch off the reed, the less air is going to make it through, and the less the air can be translated into reed vibrations, and then there's not a good sound. So what I want you to do when you're practicing, anytime you're finding yourself thinking anything about pressure, whether it's lighter fingers, more open embouchure or steady embouchure, or whatever pressure things you might be thinking with embouchure, or more air, or lighter tongue even. This comes up all the time with when working on articulation, that the tongue is trying to be lighter hitting the reed, so then the air gets lighter, and then there's not good sound at the starts of the articulation. So anytime that you find yourself thinking something pressure related, I want you to sort of check in with the other variables and make sure that you aren't doing too much of that pressure where a different pressure should be being applied. For example, if you're lightening your tongue, make sure you're not lightening your air. If you're increasing air pressure, make sure you're not increasing embouchure pressure or finger pressure. All of those things. The things have to be light in some places, firm in other places, and you have to get control over that. The ultimate answer to this is true independence of all of the variables. This is where this sort of action comes into playing the clarinet, except there's like seven different hands doing seven different motions between the air pressure, the direction of the air, the position of the tongue touching the reed, the embouchure pressure, the embouchure shape, the finger motion, the finger pressure. All of those things are playing a role, and you have to be in control of all of those things simultaneously and keeping track of them. I will say a little caveat, if you watched my video last week about the big brain versus the lizard brain, the big brain can only keep track of maybe seven things at once, so it's not at all possible to think more pressure, less pressure, this position, this motion. Like, you can't think of all of those things at once. That's why we do warm-ups to separate them into their different categories, where you can think about air and embouchure on long tones because you don't have to think about your fingers so much or tongue motion so much and those other things. So that's why we have warm-ups to separate out those variables, because you can't think of it all at once. But you do need to program into the lizard brain all of those different things that need to be happening, so that you're in good control of it subconsciously and in your muscle memory, so that your big brain, your conscious mind, is free to take care of the things that it needs to take care of, like playing the music and doing the music. But the final thing I want to say is just, when you're practicing and you're thinking of a pressure thing, consider the other variables and make sure that the one variable you're working on, whether it's air, embouchure, tongue, fingers, whatever it may be, as you're adjusting the pressure for that variable to get it dialed into what it needs to be, make sure that it's not affecting the other variables, because 90% of the time, as you do one thing on one variable, you'll want to be doing the opposite thing on the other variable. So just be aware of that. I hope thinking about this will be helpful in your practicing and give you another little thing to consider as you're playing and working on these things. And hopefully, ultimately, it makes it better. It makes your practicing more effective, makes your clarinet sound better and work more predictably, and ultimately that will lead to more joy in playing. And that's my goal, is to make playing the clarinet easier and more fun for you. So if you enjoyed this video and found it helpful, leave a like, subscribe. I upload videos like this every single Saturday morning. Thank you so much for watching this one. It's really wonderful to have people taking the time to look at these videos and hopefully get some benefits out of it. It makes my day to know that people are getting more joy out of their clarinet playing from the information that I'm providing. So really, truly, thank you for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in another video.